Hello guys, KP Shamino here with the final video for the open beta, and I'm going to say my thoughts about the beta. What did I saw that was good? What did I saw that was not so good? What are my thoughts? What they need to do in the future? So first of all, let's get started. And what I saw at the lower lakes and the higher lakes too is that I think that the travel cost is at the moment too high. At the higher levels, it's not really a big problem anymore. It's still a lot to compare to what you're earning. So if you go to Alaska, that's 25,000K. That's one day of fishing and then you got all your travel costs back, your license back. But I think on those lakes, that's not really a problem because you got a big net. You can fill that big net really quick. And you are going to get really quick the money. So you fish one day, you get all your money back. That's with premium. And then the next days you can get like a nice stash of money. So if you fish 5 days, you got roughly set 80 to 19,000 currency that you can make very easy. But I think that for the lower levels, it's way too high. I think it's way too high because those guys, they are starting with 3 kilogram net. The problem is the net is very quick full. And the problem is, then I'm come to the second thing that I don't like, is the forward speed thingy. The main problem is, like I said, in the higher levels, it's not really that hard, because I think it's 45 minutes for a total day, if you do a forward speed. But you are going to use that to just fill your big net. But in the lower level areas, your net is yeah, in like 5 seconds full. If you go to Missouri and you need to catch 3 kilograms of fish, or you go to Texas and you got a couple of smallmouth buffaloes, you fill your net in 5 minutes and then you just need to wait. Okay, you can get experience. But the main problem is that that system is not balanced. I saw it with my leveling episodes too. I was always higher in my level than I was with my currency. What do I mean with it? I always needed to go 7 to 10 areas lower, because I couldn't pay the area that was for my level. So, and there you see it was not balanced. I think that they need to find a solution for that. Just lower it maybe in the lower lakes. And yeah, I think they need to lower it everywhere, but more in the lower lakes than in the higher lakes, I think. So that's one of the negative points that I saw. I'm not sure that they just overtuned it to just check out how it is working, because it's still beta. Then the other point that I didn't like a lot, and that are the 3D Aventers. It's just my personal opinion. But I see, and why I don't like the 3D Aventers, not because I don't like people, but the main problem is they are just always in the way. At the higher level areas, that's not really a problem. But I still remember if you stand in New York on the dock, if you stand on the left side in New York, if you stand in Missouri, the problem is everybody standing on the same position and you cannot see anything anymore. So the 3D Aventers, I think it's very good for multiplayer, because I see a lot of streamers and a lot of guys that that are fishing together, and it's very cool because you see where the other guy is throwing, you see how you need to catch fish. That's a lot easier. So if you want to show somebody how you need to do it, but I hope in the future that you can just put them off, to be honest, because yeah, it's sometimes so irritating, it's unbelievable. I got my unique cutthroat trout in Colorado, and 5 seconds later, 4 people were just standing on me. And it was game over fishing for me. That's how it works. People always go to the position that they can catch the biggest fish. That's how it works. Okay. So the next thing that I want to discuss with you guys is, and that's a very positive thing, I think that the leveling system. The leveling system is not that hard anymore. So you guys saw it in my episode. So it took me 9 days with premium, of course. It's going a lot faster. I think that premium is 50% more experience and it gives more currency too. So I did 9 days. It took me 9 days and I didn't play every day because I need to go to work. I got a full-time job too. So it was every day 4 hours average. Let's say 4 to 5 hours average. So let's... Yeah, multiply it with 9, 36, let's say 50 hours with premium that you are going to need to go to the maximum level if you know all the positions, if you know the legs, if you know what you need to buy. So if you're a starting player, it's not going to happen. I think if you're a starting player with premium, it's going to take you at least 100 hours to get from 0 to 40. Is that a lot of time? I don't think so. The lakes are cool. If you like fishing, you are going to catch a lot of fish. So it's cool. If you start this game, every lake looks very beautiful in this game. So it's a lot better than before, 100%. Because the old timers, they know what you need to do to go, like, to, yeah, you couldn't go to the highest level, but what you need to do to get to level 25, or the guys, there are some guys that are even 30, that's every day just farming the whole game experience, but that's gone, and I think they did a really good job with it. That's very good. Let me think. So that was a leveling system. The currency system, yeah. Like I already said, the currency, they need to they work it a little bit better out, or they just make it a little bit higher, because you don't make a lot of currency. Even with fishing, you don't make a lot of currency. The travel costs are too high, but the income is too low too. If I see that I was in California, and on a good day you got 17,000 for each day. That's with 150 kilogram net. That's, in my opinion, is not a lot. Because you need to pay 20k to go there, you need to pay, I think, 3k every day. So it's not a lot if you see that compared to all the gear that you can buy. And I will show you guys it if you go to, let's say, a fishing net. Let's go to the fishing nets. I got this one. That's 66k, you know. If you want to get this one, that's 100k. So that's a lot of money that you need to farm, because you guys saw it during my episode. I cannot buy other gear for the simple reason that I don't have the currency. So you can have, yeah, 100k, but 100k is nothing anymore in this game. It's like just small cash, because if you buy a couple of things, your cash is gone. Then another thing that I saw, the license. They are very high too, but the fines are very high too. I got a fine of 10,000K. So 10,000K, no. 10K currency, a fine. Just like that. Here you go. And I was like, what the fuck is happening here? So you need to watch it really well. I think they need to balance that system a lot. That's what I'm thinking. And I think a lot of people think that. Then another thing, the mechanics. The mechanics, they didn't change really a lot, but they changed one important thing, and I think that's not bad, because in the past we had like two camps. We got the simulator boys and we got the farming boys. And the thing is, they find a solution in between. The farming boys can still farm. So you still got the spots, you still got the unique. I think even that you got the unique time zones, because I see a lot of guys fishing on the chain pickerel in the same time than before. But you got a random factor too. And what I mean with the random factor is that you can get a unique everywhere. I saw a video about a guy getting the unique chain pickerel all the way to the right in New York. So they are just random too. But if you want to farm them, that's still possible. You can still go to the old position. And that's a very good combination. So you got a random factor for the guys that want to do some experiments, so that want to fish everywhere. And just want to search and hunt the fish, and you got still a solution for the guys that just want to farm. Because I know guys that just want to farm cash, just want to get the experience in, just want to get the biggest fish of a certain species, and they just want to farm to get on the leaderboard. So they found a very good solution in between. It works for two sides, and I think they did a really good job there, because I saw a lot of random fish spawning on positions that normally was only one species. And that's a really good job that they did there. So I think the mechanic-wise, they tuned it really well. Then another thing that I want to discuss with you guys is the tuning. The tuning, I think that the fish was undertuned for this beta. I'm not sure that they did it on purpose, just to check out the data. But the thing is, yeah, I can get the biggest fish with my Tora. What is it? I will show you guys it with my Tora 210. So yeah, I can get all the fish with it. Yesterday I had a steelhead of 4 or 5 kilograms with a test of 1 kilogram. So it's possible and it's now fun because you can run now if you're fishing. So you can just run to the fish, just stand on his head and lift him out of the water. So you don't need to fight him anymore. So just run to him and that's really funny. So that's cool stuff what they did there. But I don't think that you need to use the system like that. So that's very good. So I said something about travel fees. I need to remember what I said. So I said something about the mechanic. That's really good. I said something about the leveling. That's really good. So what do I need to say more? Yeah, the thing, of course, the new UI. I like it a lot. It's a little bit more professional, I think. So we still got the graphic the best day is the best time in the day. It's still the same that you need to check. Inventory. Ah, inventory, they changed. Yeah, one of the most irritating stuff that you can have, that is the leg bug. So now you just can right click it like this. You see, and it's so easy now because that was such a pain in the ass. It was unbelievable. Always those legs and what was it? You cannot equip more of those items and all that stuff. So yeah, that's a really good job. Really good job. By the way, bug wise, I didn't saw a lot of bugs. Like the crankbait that keeps being invisible when you got a snag is gone. Okay, sometimes I got my lure in my eyes when I got a snag. I'm not sure what that's intended because if you are 30 meters away and you got a snag and the lure flies in your eye, I don't think it's going to happen in real life. I saw in Alaska some fish that were yeah. Doing just the same. The fish was sitting behind the rock. He got unsnagged with the fish on and he flew over me. So it's not really flying fish anymore, but it's flying fish after a snag. So they need to check it a little bit. Sometimes we got a graphical bug, but and of course, bait was pulled away from the fish. That's yeah, that was very irritating too because you cannot do anything about it. So that's okay. For the shop guys. I think that I'm not sure that's intended, but what I see like a line in the shop, what is going to happen. So for the big fish, most of the time in the areas, you need to go a little bit over the area level. So then you can buy the gear that you need. So the thing, what do I mean with it? For example, you go to California. A single and a bullet spinner is very good for the steelhead. They got now a unique. But the main problem is that's 39. California is 34. So you need to go over the level. Now I can go back because I got my first bullet spinner. And it's, by the way, 38 that I need to say. Otherwise, I cannot buy it. And you need to go back to California. So you need to go always a little bit over it. And we, of course, we got the gaps again. But I'm not sure because they need to rebalance the tuning of the fish and the gear. So, because the thing is. For the guys that followed my episodes, I already showed you guys a couple of gaps. And what do I mean with the gap? That the reel and the rod are perfectly in harmony, but that the line is like 2 kilograms under it. And then you lose a lot of strength. So that's what I mean. But it doesn't seem a problem because I think you can catch every fish here with like a low setup at the moment. So they need to tune it a little bit better, I think. I can understand it. On the other hand, I can understand it because the system works like this. If you spend bait coins, and I think in the beta we couldn't farm bait coins, by the way. I think that you are going to get bait coins from rare fish, and probably rare fish are going to be the uniques because I think that the unique name is going to go away. I don't have a problem with the name unique, but yeah. It's now something that they want to do, but they're just going to call it rare fish. So the thing is, I think that you can farm bait coins that way, and of course in competitions. But I think that bait coins are only good if you're leveling, because you got access to certain bait a little bit sooner than your level. You don't need to be overcapped in level. So the thing is, I'm not sure. You are going to get it in competitions, but what can you do with that? Of course, the forward cool down. You can, yes, keep it with bait cones. I think that at the end, the forward cool down is not going to be a problem because everybody's going to have so many bait cones. If you, of course, can get it with rare fish. If that's not the case, it's going to be very hard. But that's what I'm thinking. But they need to check it a little bit out because there are so many things that they still need to balance in the game. It's not bad, the thing, but yeah, I'm going to my last point now because I try to make a chain. Because if you don't rebalance the stuff, I'm going to the next point, and that's, I think, the most important what is going to happen. And first of all, I want to show you guys the leaderboard. So let's have a look for the guys that are interested. I'm at the moment at 159,000 experience. So let's have a look. And I need 172,000. So I think that you need in total 190,000 experience to get to level 40. So that's not a lot if you know that I needed, I think, 3 million in the main game to get to level 25. That's not a lot. I just want to show you guys that for a little bit info. So what was I saying? Yeah, the last point that I want to make, and let's go to Louisiana. Ah, I'm already in Louisiana, so let's go over here. So the last point that I want to make, this upgrade, it's cool. It's a very cool upgrade, but I'm a little bit worried for the simple reason that gameplay-wise, they didn't change a lot. So the thing is, once again, okay, you got Great Lakes, you got fish in it, but now the main problem is, what is going to happen if you're level 40? That's my concern, because the past was always the same. So the past was always the same. They got a new lake. After 4 or 5 weeks, everybody was gone. Everybody came back for the new fish. And once that they got a new fish, it stops. Because the main problem is that this is a game that you fish. But fishing is not fun in a game. You can get all the species in a game, that's true. But what then? And that's my concern at the moment with the game. So they don't have a lot of gameplay. With gameplay things, I mean that people keep coming back to the game after they are at level 40, after that they got all the species. Because why would you come back? If I'm level 40, I got every unique in the game, I got every species in the game, I got the most of the gear. Why would you keep playing the game? And that's my concern. And in the past, it was just the same, and at the moment, it's just the same too. So they didn't change anything about the gameplay. So I already sent some good stuff to, yeah, I'm not saying good stuff, but some ideas that I got. So what you need to do is now you need to implement gameplay attributes, and one of them is already in the game. That's competitions. Competitions are very good for the simple reason that people keep playing competitions. And take it from me, even now, if you go to the main game and you go to Cheesy Cat, there are a couple of 100, maybe 200 players playing Cheesy Cat. They log in to play the competition. That's a gameplay that you need. So it attracts people, they come back for the game. But it's outside the leveling, it's outside the fishing even. They just purely focus on the competitions. But if you don't like competitions, it's going to be problematic. So I was thinking about the system. You guys know that I always think about the game to improve it and to make it more attractive for myself. And I hope for other people too. So I was thinking about a system. If you go to level 40, you got a chance to reset your level again. So you start back at zero, but you keep all your gear, but all the lakes are backlogged. And at level 40, you get like a prize. Let's say I was thinking 1% chance more that you can get a fish. Something like that. So you start over again. It's going to go a lot faster because you got all the gear, you got all the money too, and you can level again. So the second time that you come at level 40, you get probably 2% chance to get more fish. And with that, so you are going to catch more uniques, more trophies. You can do with that system what you want. You don't need to give like a very big boost because the leveling is not that hard anymore, but you can give a small boost. It's going to attract people to level because they get something. or something else, you get more gold, or you get even, you can even do it like this, level 40, you just unlock other species. You can do that too. So if you make it once to level 40, you can just put five new species somewhere in an area, or stuff like that. So that there is always something after level 40, because the main problem is if I hit level 40, I'm going for all the new fish, all the uniques, and then it stops for me. Then I'm going to do competitions, but if you don't like the competitions, yeah, you're fucked, you know. The other thing, what you need to do with that system is, and I already say it now for 6 months, because I said it in my Alaska thoughts too, is you need to do something with the leaderboard. And I'm always said, make it like a 3 month league. And all the guys that got the highest weight fish in the species, and with all the species, I mean all the species, I mean the white sucker in Colorado, I mean the chain pickerel in New York, those guys get a prize. And what is a good prize? You can get a skin. For example, we got now 3D Aventers. You can get a hat. You can get a custom-made rod with your name on it. You can have a bobber with your colors on it. That stuff players like. And in the combination with the leveling system, with a 1% more chance, that work really great. Because people need to level because your chance is higher that you get a bigger fish. So it correlate really well with each other. And what is the advantage from that is that people are going to fish more in the lower lakes because you need to level up again. You start in Texas. And people are going to go for every species too. Because now at the moment, people are just going to Alaska to the new lake for a couple of weeks and then they stop. So that was just my idea about getting gameplay in. And that's. I don't think it's a very bad idea, but I'm not sure that they are going to do it. But that was my concern because at some point the game looks cool, it's fishing, but at some point people are here to level, people are here to get the cash in, people are here to get the biggest fish. It works like that. Fishermen don't talk about their smallest fish, no, they talk about their biggest fish. And that's how it works. If I catch here a unique and there is somebody standing over there, he's coming to stand on me because he want to catch the unique. That's how it works. And they need to find a solution for that problem. And I think if they can find a very good solution that players keep playing this game and not every update after a couple of weeks they just stop again, I think they are on gold. Because the frame is good, the area is good, the mechanics are good. It looks good, but they still need to make it addictive. And that's very important in a game. And then I think this game is good. Or they can do it just the other way around too. Every 3 months they make a new lake, but then you are going to always need to make new lakes. And yeah, it's a never-ending story. I don't think that with the people that they got at the moment, the developer team, that they can achieve that every couple of months a new lake. I think that's way too much. But that was it, guys, my thoughts. So overall, I'm very positive about the beta. There are some flaws, there are some very good things, but at the end, I think that the developers are doing a very good job. So keep it up, guys. And yeah, I see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching, guys. Have fun in Fishing Planet, and see you the next time. Bye bye.